Hey, it's me, Peng. My biggest wish today is that I get the chance to interview Miss Kenning Folk. He's the older grandson of Henry Folk, and he married one of the most successful female divers. And he's extremely popular, and the video we made with him last year was viewed 6 million times on our platforms. But after what happened to me yesterday, it's obviously not easy to interview whoever you want. First, you need to run. Second, we need a map. So this is the map. The Great Hall of the People is the main venue for the two sessions, and it's located on the western side of the Tiananmen Square.
In the center of the building is the Cavernous Great Auditorium that can seat 10,000 people. There are smaller halls for China's provinces.
This lovely painting illustrates a group of friends, which symbolize longevity in Chinese culture. And in this building, you can see a lot of traditional art from all over China.
大哥，你为啥坐这儿？我在这儿弄稿子啊。 Now I'm trying to get hold of Kenny Folk's assistant. One of my colleagues gave me his number.
您好，您拨打号码是空号，请最后再拨。
The number you have dialed is not in service.
I'm now at the living quarters of the CPPCC members. It may sound like I'm an undercover reporter, but it's a routine for reporters to come here looking for stories.
Perhaps we can see Kenneth here?
You are the chair of the Athletes Commission of Beijing 2022. I wonder how is the preparation going?
It's going very well. The coordination commission from IOC, we were here last September. And they analyze everything, and everything is going smooth, and everything is on the track. So now it's we focus on the all the venues. The venues will be finished at the end of this year, most venues. So we have to be ready in, before 2021.
Then what will happen to this venue after the Olympic Games?
There will most the venue will be. The venue for training, for the national team, for the people come to enjoy the sports, for the events later on. We established a sustainability program for the Olympic legacy after Olympics. Okay. And venue is a part of this. Mm-hmm. It's not only one-time thing, so it's long-term, and where we have a lot of plan for after Olympics.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, my little girl is 3 years old already, and she's an Olympic baby, definitely. She's very active, and she got on the ice a couple times.
Okay.
She loves sports. I don't know if she's going to choose winter sports, but I will definitely provide opportunity.
Welcome to Beijing. He looks very familiar to me. But 您好，您是敖老师吗？是。哎，你好，你好。
I'm very proud of my professor in last year, AED distribution.
And then because everyone knows, and when the people have cardiac arrest, after this cardiac, not really arrest, yeah, fibrillation. Usually like heart beat like this, and then when they stop, just initial several minutes, like this, okay. By that time, we give electrical shock, and then we call it auto electronic defibrillator.
The AED. And we important if we use as early as possible, the early. The AED. And then the success rate will go higher. I went to Xinjiang to Ravender to give talk, health education, and medical doctor training, and to diagnose the patient without any money. And then,
the medical treatment is a really difficult science.
We can't predict the patient after treatment. I ask patient to understand more doctors.
doctors have to have improved their technique and level. It would be prevent this kind of conflict between patient and the doctors.
Kenny Focus just walked past. Did I film it?
你好。Hi, I'm from China Daily.
I'm not gonna. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Thank you.
Spring is coming.
After talking with Ao Huxian, I was wondering why we are always pursuing celebrities. After all, we don't have to be famous to do something really important.